It finally arrived. In this box is the brand new 14-inch Apple MacBook Pro in silver, of course, with the brand new M1 Pro processor. Let's go ahead and open it. Apple's really starting to make these unboxing quite easy because they don't even need a knife anymore or scissors. It's all just modular. Because as you can see, here is the brand new MacBook Pro. 14-inch, 10-core CPU, 16-core GPU, 32GB of RAM, I meant for the RAM upgrade, and of course a 1TB SSD. This is the MacBook Pro I've been using up until now. This is my main laptop. It's the 2018 MacBook Pro spec'd out 15-inch. Oh, we've been through a lot, this laptop, this bloody butterfly keyboard. They do make it very easy. There is something quite weird about undressing a new laptop. Or the new same map make it weird. Lovely. We've been waiting so long for a really great MacBook Pro, and I think the thing I'm most excited about is the brand new screen. You know, the mini LED, 120Hz refresh rate. This is the big opening. This is nice. This is hot. This is heavy. It's definitely a heavy laptop for such a small size. Like, I think some people might like that, might feel sturdy, but it's heavy for a 14-inch MacBook for sure. There's a little pull tab here. Oh yeah. Oh, silver, my old friend. The engraving is very beautiful. It gives it a very premium feel. You know, when we saw the pictures, a lot of people were describing it kind of like a PowerBook or the old MacBook Pros. It's quite, there's a word for it though. They went with a brutalist design for the new MacBook Pro. It's no longer meant to be sleek or sexy. Everything about it means business. I mean, it's sexy in its own way, but it's definitely a brutalist design compared to the older one, which was a lot more refined, a lot more elegant. You can just see from how it's been designed that they really went for more of a brutalist approach to the new look. And I have to say, I like it because who doesn't like brutalist? It feels very utilitarian. I have to say, I got used to the USB-C and Thunderbolt ports, but the CDSD card slot back is nice. But I have to say, for the pro and enterprise market, you're going to be very happy to see HDMI back. I was at a conference one time, and it was a proper professional, a solicitor. And she was giving us a talk, and she had a TV. And she had one of the new MacBook or the older MacBooks that had USB-C on it, and the TV didn't recognize the MacBook, or the MacBook didn't recognize the TV. And there was an extra layer of frustration because she didn't have to just diagnose if her MacBook wasn't working or if the TV wasn't working, but you also have to diagnose if it's the dongle. Is the dongle causing the issues? And of course, MagSafe is back. I missed MagSafe. I'm excited to use this. Yeah. Thank you, MagSafe. Thanks for returning. What else is in the box? We'll put the MacBook there. Let's have a look. We've got our new MagSafe wire. Love this. It's braided too. I'm very careful with my Apple packaging. I don't know why I'm so precious with it. Like, some people are just absolute animals. But I'm always like, oh, you're so precious. I need to look after you. Okay. This is the most intricate cable. Why don't you just like wrap the paper on it and fold it up? Like, this seems like a lot. Oh, MagSafe. Oh, missed you. This is the new power brick that supports fast charging. Thankfully, I've been a Mac user for quite a while, so I still have the extension lead for this charger from like one of my very old MacBooks. And it still works. You do not need to buy a new extension lead if you have one of the older style ones. They still work perfectly. And this is some new documentation. I heard we got some new stickers. I actually don't really typically play with the stickers, but you know, for you guys, I'll show you them. These are your new Apple stickers, and they're black because they're for professionals, because professionals will use black stickers. Drop a comment down below and let me know if you actually use your Apple stickers, because I've never used my Apple stickers on anything. All right, first boot. Oh, no one does it quite like Apple. That screen is amazing. You notice the screen straight away. Apple kind of glossed over it in their keynote, I think because of the mixed reaction to the M1 iPad Pro, but the screen on this, wow. And now it says hello to you. I like this. It kind of brings back the good old days of when the Mac used to sing to you when you'd, you know, turn it on for the first time. I was taking in the keyboard. It's quite a shock. It's very, very black. I don't see orange.
English is the main language. Press the okay. return key.
So I'm looking at the notch. It isn't that bad. I mean, you are going to look at her. She is there. I always recommend when you set up a new MacBook or an iMac or anything, just start fresh and copy over your files manually. A lot of people like to do a time machine backup. Agree, Apple. I have to say, I like the 14-inch screen size. It isn't too small. It actually feels quite good. I think when you go from a 15-inch to a 13-inch MacBook, like you did back in the old days, I think you notice a difference, but you have so much screen on such a small package. It's very, very attractive. So it's setting up Touch ID, this still works as great as ever. So this is the brand new MacBook Pro. We just booted in. The screen is pretty lovely. Oh, the function row keys, you know, the touch bar is gone. It is nice to have those function row keys back. You do get used to it pretty quickly. You know where the key is and you know what the key does. So this is the older 15.4-inch MacBook Pro. And as you can see, the size difference is huge, and only for an inch of screen real estate. I think that's why if you have a 15 inch, I consider going for the 14 inch, because you're only losing an inch, but you're losing a lot more in overall volume. Oh, goodbye touch bar. This will be sold, basically. That's what's gonna happen. I thought we'd compare this to the first Intel MacBook Pro. This is the first MacBook I ever owned. So you can kind of see, look at that. That's the first ever Intel MacBook Pro. And this is the first ever M1 Pro Professional MacBook Pro by Apple. And they are strikingly similar in terms of their brutalist design language, because obviously this was quite popular back in the day. So I think it looks good. I'm just so happy to have a silver laptop again. It's so much nicer than space gray. This is lovely. If you have any questions or anything you want me to test on this particular configuration of the MacBook Pro, again, M1 Pro, 32 gigs of RAM, 1 terabyte SSD, drop a comment down below and let me know, and I'll try to answer that for you in a future video. But I think we're gonna leave it off here. Thank you so much for watching. Do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to stay tuned for future MacBook Pro coverage. I'm gonna test this thing out a lot more than we have just have. We're gonna do more extensive testing. But do give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the unboxing and the comparison that I did today. I hope you guys are keeping safe and well, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, everybody.